And in other news today, the government of Afghanistan claimed that security forces have regained control of the city of Kunduz from the Taliban. They said they recaptured the center of the embattled northern city after a six-hour assault overnight. After daybreak, Afghan security forces could be seen patrolling the streets. They hunted for retreating Taliban fighters as fighting continued in places. But President Ashraf Ghani claimed victory.
We praise the security officials of our country for their tireless efforts leading the war from 10 p.m. last night until the early morning, and during the rest of the day they managed to successfully launch operations. The good news is that we didn't have anyone martyred.
The NATO coalition confirmed that U.S. special forces fought alongside Afghan groups in the battle, returning fire in self-defense. The United Nations Refugee Agency now says it expects 1.4 million migrants and refugees to arrive in Europe this year and next, up sharply from an estimate just a month ago. That report today came as new waves of people, mainly Syrians, kept pouring into Serbia and Croatia, aiming to move on to Western Europe. They face the prospect of worsening weather with the onset of fall. Closer to home, Hurricane Joaquin raked the central Bahamas today, and forecasters said it is now extremely dangerous. Sustained winds reached 130 miles an hour and could get even stronger. The storm's future course was being closely watched, as late projection showed that it is more likely to track away from the U.S. mainland next week. In the meantime, people up and down the East Coast were urged to get ready. Disaster officials warn people against waiting to see exactly where Joaquin is headed.
We can't always tell where these storms are going to go. And if you're, you know, waiting to the last minute, it may be too late. We've got time. This storm is down in the Bahamas. It's not going to come out of there quickly. So if you're from the Carolinas through the New England states, if you didn't get ready for hurricane season, this is your time. This is October 1st. Get ready.
The states of Maryland, New Jersey, and Virginia declared emergencies today in advance of the storm. The U.S. House of Representatives has set the stage for a possible veto showdown with President Obama over defense spending. Republicans today passed a bill authorizing $612 billion. It gives the president much of what he wants by padding a warfighting account. The White House says that that would break through defense spending caps. The Senate gets the bill next week. In New York City, the police department today unveiled new rules on the use of force after a highly critical report. The city's inspector general found the NYPD has no clear-cut guidelines for officers on using force, and he said too often the department does not discipline those who go too far. Under the new guidelines, officials said today, police will have to document every time they use force, even in brief encounters.
I speak to the issue of the sanctity of human life. We are one of the few in government that have the power, the authority, to take a life, to take people into custody, to deprive them of their liberty. So that sanctity of life, that respect for life, has to be paramount.
New York police have come under scrutiny in the chokehold death of Eric Garner in 2014. More recently, a policeman roughed up former tennis star James Blake after mistaking him for a criminal suspect. In economic news, auto sales in the U.S. showed double-digit gains in September. Ford led the way with a 23% jump, but Volkswagen sales were stagnant amid a scandal over cheating on pollution tests. And on Wall Street, stocks were mixed as investors awaited tomorrow's jobs report. The Dow Jones Industrial Average lost 12 points to close near 16,270. The Nasdaq rose nearly 7 points, and the S&P 500 added 3.